Morning. Today's first topic for presentation is a prospective randomized phase 2 trial of single fraction versus multi-fraction spinal SRS. As we all know that oligometastatic state is hypothesized to represent an intermediary state between widely metastatic disease and curable localized disease. Within this group, an opportunity arises where targeted treatment toward limited metastasis may confer disease and even possibly survival advantages. Spinal SRS increases the therapeutic window by achieving delivery of higher BED and lowering the risk for spinal cord myelopathy and other critical OIR toxicity. There have been multiple studies which has compared the conventional radiotherapy with SRS with local control as high as 90%. Despite the observed high local control rate, optimal schedule of SRS for patients with limited spinal metastasis is not well established and has never been investigated in a prospective randomized trial. As we all know that multiple studies have assessed the role of SRS in limited spinal metastasis using different dose fractionation schedule, of which a few important are summarized in this table. They demonstrated local control rates ranging from 72% to as high as 96%. Present study was aimed to compare two spinal SRS schedules to determine which results in the lowest rate of treatment-related toxicity. Patients with biopsy-proven non-hematogenous malignancy and limited unirradiated spine metastasis not requiring upfront spine surgery were eligible. There should not be any leptomeningeal or intramedullary involvement on imaging, and not more than three sites of involvement with a maximum involvement of two contiguous vertebra, a KPS of more than 60, and life expectancy of at least 4 months were considered. It was an open label randomized phase 2 trial having two arms. First arm received single fraction, 16 gray single fraction with BED 10 of 41.60 gray, whereas second arm received 24 gray in three fraction with BED of 43.2 gray. They were all treated using IMRT, VMAT, and RapidR. Primary endpoint was to compare two spinal SRS schedules to determine which results in lowest rate of grade 3 or higher protocol-specified adverse events at 4 months. Secondary analysis included time to treatment failure, which was defined as presence of grade 3 or higher adverse events or unequivocal local progression of treated spine indicative of re-irradiation or surgical intervention. For radiotherapy treatment planning and target delineation, MRI fusion was used. CTB was defined as the spinal tumor with intraosseous margins of 5 to 8 mm within the involved spinal level. Entire vertebral body IVDs and both pedicles were not routinely included when uninvolved. All patients were treated with LINAC-based SBRT using VMAT via dynamic conformal arcs. CBCT before each arc was employed as image guidance to confirm setup accuracy. Between November 15 and October 2018, a total of 50 patients were enrolled for spinal SRS, including 40 lung cancers, two each from breast, head and neck, liver and prostate, and one each from colon and thymic cancer. Of these 50 patients, 26 were randomized to single fraction arm and 24 to multi-fraction arm. Median age was 62 years and median follow-up time was 16.3 months. A total of 77 metastatic spinal levels were treated, which included one cervical, 42 thoracic, 31 lumbar, and three sacral site for SRS. Nine out of these 50 patients had epidural invasion, four in single fraction arm and five in multi-fraction arm. At 4 months, none of the 25 evaluable patients in single fraction arm experienced any protocol specified grade 3 or higher toxicities, but one out of 21 in multi-fraction arm underwent surgical intervention due to progressive compression fracture. None developed radiation-induced myelopathy. During longer follow-up, three patients in single fraction arm and six additional patients in multi-fraction arm developed treatment failure. Median time to failure was 13.5 months in single fraction arm, whereas it was 8 months in multi-fraction arm. 1 year treatment failure rate was significantly worse in multi-fraction arm at 14.3%, which was statistically significant. To conclude, single fraction spinal SRS has met primary endpoint with low risk of treatment-related high-grade toxicity at 4 months. Initial secondary analysis suggests 16 gray single fraction might be the preferable spinal SRS schedule due to less treatment failure events after longer follow-up. Thank you.